Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome you to episode 22. Now that's Emmitt Smith's number. He's my favorite running back ever in the NFL. Number of the Vikings van, episode 22. Woo! Whoa! Whoa! It's crazy.
Like a wave.
wait, we got five?
Five.
So that's 20.
Right now.
Two! Yeah. We're down over here at the Pacifico for
the
love of house.
In the house.
In the house. In the van tonight, we have Pineo. Pineo, my boy.
Steve.
What's going on, man?
What's happening, man?
All kinds of craziness lately, all kinds of craziness. But for you.
For me.
You are nominated, sir. See, okay, now he was just spinning down over at Pacifico, over in the Capitol, which is when you get a chance to actually go to Pacifico, you can go just for the normal dance floor, that's one price. You can go for the VIP, way more bumping, and that's where this guy was spinning.
$3 drinks. It sells itself.
It certainly pays for itself, really, when you get right down to it.
Yeah.
Well, thanks for coming out. Yeah, like you're nominated for Halifax,
Nova Scotia. DJ
Music Nova Scotia. Much props, Music Nova Scotia. I just had Rich O'Coin in the van.
Yeah, he was up for tons of them.
Eight of them.
I voted for like a bunch. Like, very talented.
So like, I mean, how does that make you feel? Like, is this your first time?
Yeah, first time for DJ of the year, because, I mean, I've really, like, been DJing, like, I've been in this scene for, like, just a bit, little over a year, so, like, to be in that, it's, like, really, it means a lot, and I'm up, like, with guys like T-Woo, who's, like, I'm a big fan of him, and,
man,
like,
he's been at it forever.
Oh, yeah, like, he's been nominated.
He's spinning up at the Seahorse tonight.
The Palace.
Oh, the Palace. The Palace tonight. Yes, with Clockwork.
I was playing some of Clockwork's songs today in honor of him.
Nice.
He didn't be there, but yeah, and then like DJ Ivy, who like wins all the time.
Who is classes?
Classified
DJ. Yeah.
So like to be just like on like the same list.
RS Smooth.
Playboy.
Yeah, Playboy. Like that's like a. I mean, and we're not just talking. See, I cover a lot in the EDM, electronic dance music. For those who are still not quite in the know. I cover a lot of the underground, the stuff that's not usually brought to light. But there are still other DJs who I will, of course, be getting to, like RS Smooth and some of the other guys who spin underground, but then they also know how to cater to like even a radio crowd, which is a little bit, you know, I mean, that's a tad bit of a jump when you actually have your own personal taste as a DJ, whether mixing or producing. Like yourself, but then you got to be able to spin all the things. So it's really interesting for you to be in that group because for the most part, you have a hip hop DJ, you have a house DJ with T-Woo,
A Wallace is there. He's a producer. Well, he just kind of does like more like 110, kind of a bit slower house, and then like T-Woo does a bit more like hip hop influenced stuff. And he has a really good variety too. I've learned a lot like playing from shows with him. Like he definitely knows how to get people going. You know?
Well, it's actually it was at a T-Woo show that we were at over at the Seahorse in episode one. When I ran into Evan Frizzle and a number of my friends, and we just decided to do episode number one, so that was pretty cool.
That's how it started. Yeah,
yeah, it's crazy. I love how Halifax really has that sort of everybody is involved with everybody because it sort of forces that overlap.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, it forces.
I've seen this going down. I've been like leaving the Seahorse and like saw like the Viking van stuff going down, walk in front of it or something.
Actually, you know what? It's actually very not. It's very common for people to come up and just say
like,
hi or wave,
or
like woo, or like we were with twice during the Orchid's Curse one on St. Patrick's Day. We had people go by and they went woo, and all the guys in the van go woo. Back, yeah.
We're a little more hidden. This is more safe.
Yeah, oh yeah. Well, we also have excellent. Yeah, but now, okay. So, yeah, it's great to be in the company. But how big would it be for you to win that category in?
It would be. I can't even like. I thought about it like as soon as I like was nominated. It was like there's no way I could win. Like, but like if I did like. what would I even do? Like, they have, like, well, a really great trophy and, like,
static. What do you think makes you different than some of the other ones? I have a particular thought in mind, because you received a huge bunch of recognition back in the spring, I believe. Or was it the winter?
That was the winter. Yeah, well, part of the, like, a lot of the other guys have been nominated, like, many years in a row, and I've kind of, like, a bit different coming in. A lot of these guys have been in the scene for a long time, so me coming in
so
here
bad
is, like,
props
a younger...
to every one of them.
Oh, absolutely. It's different, like, coming in, being, like, a younger producer like that. It kind of, like, sets me a bit apart in, like, in many ways, and that kind of, like, gives me a disadvantage and an advantage at the same time.
Well, see, now, the particular thing I'm kind of referring to is the one that really actually kind of introduced me to you. I think I know
what you're talking about.
There was a contest back in February.
It was December.
December.
Yeah.
And it was Lights and her song Toes. Mitchell had a remix of it. It's you can find it on YouTube. I'll place a link to it down in the description. I like it better than the original.
That means a lot. Like, I had, like, a couple people say that to me, and I was like,
it's
really
the synth, man. It gives it a real, it gives it a way more, you know,
That's exactly it. Like, I wanted to have, like, something else catchy in there, and that's so crazy. Like, that people were saying that to me after, because, like, Holy Fuck did the synth. Like, you know, the band, they played it, like, Evolve, the headline. They produced that song, actually.
Who did?
Holy Fuck.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like, the band that's playing that Evolve, and they're, like, amazing, and they...
Love... Much love. Holy fuck,
oh,
love.
Oh, yeah.
There we are.
They're,
holy
fuck. Like, meeting
I
them.
Said that. You know what? I'm not even taking it back. Straight up, hardcore,
yeah.
100% all the time, nothing but what? Win. Right.
That's it.
High fives for all that.
And I got to meet them at Evolve, because I was doing, like, sound and, like, helping out, like, tech back there, and I met the guys, and I was just like, thank you for that song. Like, that was awesome. They helped produce it there. And then, of course, I did my own thing on that, which was just, like, weird, like, you know, to try to just, like, take the existing song and basically reproduce it. Like, do all my own instruments, but just keep the vocals the same they were.
Yeah.
The way they were.
Which, and it worked out great. You, because of your, here's the props, okay? People voted. Now, people voted around the world.
So many people. It was insane.
And you came out number one in what people liked.
Woo!
Mad props.
Thank you.
Mad
I can't
props.
I can't believe that happened, because the guy who was in number two, he you know Ellie Goulding? Do you know her?
I don't know.
She's like basically like similar to Lights. She's like Skrillex's girlfriend. Really, really huge artist. She had a remix contest, and that guy won it, and he got a massive fan base. He had like 10,000 fans on Facebook. So he comes up for the Lights remix contest and remixes her. And so he has already a huge fan base there, and they all vote for him. And so that was when it started. It was kind of weird, because it was like me and him back and forth, and people were looking at our fan pages, and they're like, this guy's like 10,000 fans, and this guy's like 300 fans. How can they even be competing?
But then they listen to it.
Yeah, well, like, a big thing was, like, people on Facebook, like, all just friends sharing. It got so viral in that way that just so many people were voting for it.
I'm not gonna lie, I shared the bejesus out of that.
I really appreciate it, because I
loved it, but...
It couldn't have happened without people doing that.
I would really love to see some of these episodes of the Vikings van.
Share
the bejesus.
It makes
wait, subscribe. Subscribe right up here. You know, make sure you... Monkey, you tell him. Wait.
Can we see the monkey?
Well done. Okay, very good, monkey. But yeah, so... We can touch on how... I mean, you're going to be up in Liverpool.
Yeah,
for
Music Nova Scotia Week.
Because you got to find out if you win.
Yeah, and I'm playing a show, too. Like, a
oh,
part
really?
Of the showcase. Yeah, they booked me for that before I even found out.
Which showcase?
I don't know yet. Probably something electronic. And I'm doing Halifax Pop Explosion as well.
Are you going to be up over at the Palace?
It's at Gus's Pub. It's different.
Oh!
It's kind of interesting, though,
because,
like...
See, I it hurts my soul, because I'm going to be playing up Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. I'm stage managing.
Oh,
wait,
cool.
Pop X?
Yeah, Tuesday. It's the first day. I'm the first act of the first day of the Pop Explosion. So you go to the schedule, and I'm the first name you see, which is really cool.
The schedule, which is now posted up on the Halifax Pop Explosion group site.
Yeah.
You can find it on Twitter. You can find it on...
Awesome.
Yeah, what is it? HPX.
I don't know what the website is. I should know that because we're helping a lot with that.
Or is it Halifax PX?
Google Halifax Pop Explosion. You'll be good.
There you go. You'll find them all.
But they kind of booked me as more, instead of like a DJ in like the club scene, it was more of like an artist. So I'm playing with like the, I forget what it was. It was like Humans. And they're playing, and they're kind of like a live electronic band. It was really cool to be playing with them because I feel like they're booking me more for my music. Because that's like the position you're in. It's like, are you a producer or are you
now,
a DJ?
Okay. Now, obviously, I mean, going out and playing music, DJ, you make money. It's a thing to do.
It's great.
But now, producing, though, that's your art. Right? Like, that's where you get to take part of what you do, and you get to turn it into something that you hear. Because I listen to Radio Steve. I don't know about anybody else. I know they probably aren't listening to Radio Steve. You're pretty intuitive. I sometimes think you are, but... but the thing is that when you hear a jam, and then in your head you hear... Man, I could mix this song into it. So then that's like the DJ overlapping
two
songs.
Aspects.
But then you can like create your own because you have the technical expertise to be, you know, like what was your background? Did you actually have a musical background?
Well, I played in a band. Basically, how my whole electronic music career started is I was in a band playing with a couple other people.
What
and
was
I always,
the band?
What
was the band?
It was a joke band. It was called ALBM. And
ALBM?
Yeah.
Now, what was that for? Oh, come on. It's for the Vikings fan.
Aaron's Lloyd's Baby Massacre is what it was. We just picked the stupid...
Aaron's Lloyd's Baby Massacre.
The stupidest
for
name
the
we
win.
Could. And we wrote stupid songs, and it was funny. I wrote a song about a boat.
Like a boss.
My dad was building a boat, and I saw a frame of the boat, and I was like, okay, I wonder... We were just like, what do we write a song about? And my friend was like, write a song about that. And I was like, that's the worst idea ever. Okay, we should do it, you know? And so we wrote that, and we were like doing the band and playing and stuff, but I was really annoyed that we couldn't practice as much as I wanted to. I wanted to play music every day. So I like installed like Fruity Loops on my computer, and I tried to like make the song with like me singing and stuff, but in Fruity Loops and produced it there, and I made the electronic music, and I listened to it after, and I was like, I made this whole song by myself, like without a band, and like it felt like really gratifying to do all aspects and have whole control over the song.
It's almost like a composer.
That's exactly it.
Like who would create for a symphony.
Writing
it's
like
just
sheet music like that. All the different aspects instead of like just playing the drums like it was before. Like I had to write the melodies and the bass and all that. And it was like a really, really natural transition, and it felt great. Like
now, what kind of program do you use to?
I use Logic now, the Apple one. But like, I've dabbled with a bunch of them, like Ableton, and like you move on, you kind of figure out what you like the most, and that's it every time.
Like Ill Gates and interviewed Eviction,
Eviction's
love
amazing.
Ableton. A bunch of the guys love him.
Yeah, he's great.
But you know, I mean, like it's interesting too because recently I've had a couple of like Eviction and Wrecked Bitch. They've been showing me how. Actually pretty once you figure out how to use these programs you can actually create the way a person who gets inspired to paint you just go and then you just kind of start adding things
all the little details and it's like you color it too. Coloring your like your project is a really important thing too. I find like making the vibe, like if it's a chill song you get more blue and like purple and
I'm
stuff.
Always about vibe.
You know me, so right? Like you're sitting there and you're looking at the song and you physically like see the song right there. Like that was never really happened when you were like writing with like a band, like so you might write it down, but this is like the whole song right there in front of you.
So now let's change channels on this. Where let's assume that okay, maybe you win or you don't win the Nova Scotia Music Award.
Yep.
But the fact that that puts you bigger on the map.
Absolutely.
The nomination itself, like obviously being a member of Music Nova Scotia has got to be a boon to you, a good thing.
Oh, for sure. It's like a resume thing now. It's like, well, I was nominated for that, you know.
But it even allows you, I just from my experience dealing with Music Nova Scotia, it was, and Nova Scotia Music Week, which is going to be such a good time. Like,
yeah. This is
like,
going to be my first one.
Like, for anybody that lives near the area, or, it, you know, if you can manage a road trip to wherever these are going, the shows are unbelievable, because it's all top playbill entertainment.
Absolutely.
The entire time. Just
I'm
sure
working
you...
on it, too. Like, we're doing volunteering every day, because the school I go to now is, like, they help set it up and organize it and everything.
What school do you go to?
NSCC for music business.
So oh, yeah.
We're right in there.
Or yeah, with Way?
Yeah, Way.
High five.
Mason.
Way Mason, yeah, yeah, man. Yeah,
I'll tag him in that.
Oh, for sure, for sure. But, yeah, it's... The thing is that I find that development as an artist, it, like, how much do you find that the other artists that you rub elbows with have an effect on how you approach your production?
Oh, it's huge. Like, I played shows with A.A. Wallace a lot after, and then I was like, I've got a real appreciation for the more down-tempo. Like, I was doing everything 128 before that, and then playing with him, like, the more groovy stuff. That's why I remixed him and did, like, this 110 BPM track, just because I see, like, the way his music affects the crowd, and I want to be able to do that as well. Like, all the different BPMs and the beats affect people differently, and you want to be able to have those options.
Well, yeah, and because I've always found that it sort of affect, like, if you get into it, it affects your heartbeat.
Oh, huge, huge.
Right, because then you're just like...
The kick drum is like, you feel it in your chest, the bass.
Yeah, like I said, you can always, you know, one of these days I'm going to do a Vikings van where it's just, I'm going to have different artists come in and we're just going to, like, beatbox just for the, you know, shits and giggles.
Do a theme song.
If you had to say there were two excellent venues, like, in a world of awesome, oh, fans, hi, when you're in the scene, what venues do you really dig playing at?
There's two ends of the spectrum. As a DJ, I love playing at, like, Pacifico, because I love the vibe there. It's a great, like, it's an amazing looking place, so well done, and it's really fun to, like, play music that you want people to dance to there. And then the other end of that is the Seahorse, where you feel like more of, like, an artist there instead of, like, a DJ doing a service. You're playing, like, alongside, like, Whaleskin and people like that, and it's like I'm playing my own music.
Zhuang, oh man, yeah.
Yeah. But like, playing my own stuff there, you feel like people are, like, listening more instead of just, like, they're dancing, like, this is, which is great too, but, like, they're paying attention, like, and I love playing my originals there, and that's it. I feel more like an artist, and which is,
well, really, yeah, great. Like, this is, and that's interesting because there's similar classy vibes at both places. But Pacifico has more of a almost like a consumer, right? The people who may or may not come out, they'll enjoy what they hear, and they may even look further. But Seahorse, you almost have a bit more of a discerning crowd. And, I mean, I've seen you play up at all kinds of places.
Palace.
Yeah, the Palace. That was fun. When it was the, was that the producer?
Hemp. Oh, yeah, and the producer competition.
Yes.
There too. I played all original. That was cool, too.
Yeah.
I love playing all original. That's usually what I do at the Seahorse. And
what do you think of the shift lately? I mean, you've got somebody who admittedly played a lot of, you know, dubstep and kind of that sort of genre, the bassy stuff, like P80.
Yeah.
And then you have Bird, Jay Bird. Gonna have you in the van sometime soon, buddy. I know he's playing right now.
He's great. Oh, he's playing.
yeah, alongside Steve Nurse.
Awesome.
Jules Bangsworth just finished up.
Yeah, her house set was awesome.
Oh, it was. But I told. Oh, Jaybird. Yeah, Jaybird house. Right. Straight up house. He as well has been doing this ghetto funk. I gotta tell you, man, I see a lot of potential in that, especially with, especially on the making of a new track, because Way will agree, copyright lasts how many years, do you know?
Oh, we talked about this in class, like, yesterday.
Huh?
No, that was, I don't know, like, it's like intellectual property, I think it's like 60 years or something. Hey.
Oh, they're doing it.
Hey, what's going on?
We got,
you know what? Come on in. Come on in. Sure.
We got
Record Bitch. We got Record Bitch coming in.
Come on in.
And we got Big Vega.
Woo!
DJ Synthetics.
What's up?
Popping in the van. Man, this just got a whole lot more cuddly.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yes.
Right. So wait. We're in the middle of episode 22, and we just got bushwhacked.
Fucking bombarded.
By
destroyed.
By DJ Synthetics.
Ow!
And
man,
Wrecked
yo.
Bitch.
How you doing?
For his second time. So we were just actually pretty much getting ready to round it all up.
Yep.
But the basics are there's just a lot of awesome going on in Halifax. The bushwhack sort of throws a crazy curve, but you know what? That's Halifax.
Yeah.
Because we were talking about the overlaps and like ghetto funk and how.
The way I see it is, it's just more tools in the toolbox, you know? Like, you got dubstep now, you got Moomba, you got trap, you got ghetto funk, and you have house, and you can put it all together and make your sets way more interesting.
You know,
but yeah, with copy,
it's music.
Oh yeah.
It's music.
That's what we were...
It's
with,
fucking music.
That's, straight up. And that's what we were saying, that's where we were going with that. The ghetto funk allows, because it taps into jazz.
Oh yeah.
But jazz is over 70 years old in some cases.
It's an excellent.
Which means we're allowed to use...
Sample these jazz artists.
For free.
Yeah, it's like electric swing. You ever hear electric swing?
Yeah.
I love
But I mean, what you do is you just go crazy with it.
Yeah.
King of the Swingers, the fucking Jungle Book track.
It's
I play
so
that shit,
cool,
man. Tommy's playing it tonight right now in PC.
Caravan.
Oh,
yeah.
Have you heard it before? The King of the Swingers.
Yeah. Now,
check it out.
Oh, wait, okay. Actually, let's bring that up as a shout out as well, guys. PC East. Going on
as we speak
up in
Stewiac, by the fucking Mastodon,
Mastodon Ridge there, you know, the blueberry craziness up there. Yeah, PCs, good times. I'm gonna try and make it up there tomorrow night.
We'll see.
Wreck a bitch in Moldilox.
Oh yeah, and what time is that set?
They're 2:30. Me and Amanda are opening for them. Like, we're doing 1 to 2:30.
Don't damage my pork. It's okay.
Well, thanks for letting us on the show, man. I appreciate it.
But anyway,
wrapping this up.
Yeah, well, the basics are. It's just that there's so many things that are going on. How can people not get more involved and get out, see what's going on, check it all out. Get involved. Artists, if you're not involved, if you're producing things and you're songwriting, if you're not a member of SOCAN, and if you don't know what SOCAN is, SOCAN, look that up, okay?
It's huge. Yeah,
like, because when it comes to learning about copyright and trademark, listen to Way in class, it's nothing but win. Right, the guy knows his stuff.
Oh, he's like, you can vote for him now. He's
yes, I know.
Council.
Going for council.
Yeah,
nothing but win, Way. Nothing but win. Anyway, folks, minions, thanks for coming out for episode 22 of the Vikings Van. Episode 22. Anyway, minions. That was just like into infinity. That's gonna blow someone's mind. Anyway, thanks for coming out, guys. Minions, we'll be seeing you guys really soon. Womp Halifax, Dom Halifax, subscribe to the channel. Make sure you like down here on the bottom. That's what lets people know this is actually good stuff. And
like it.
Mitch, you are a handsome young feller, I gotta tell you.
Thank you.
Post
that shit to my wall, motherfucker.
Oh,
this
post
one
it everywhere.
And you.
For sure, buddy man. Anyway, minions, thanks a lot. We're gonna go back and check at the Pacifico. We're gonna go check out
Burden Nurse.
Ooh. And then we're gonna see if we can't run into DJ Collette over at Reflections, or as I like to call it, Rejections. Anyway, peace out, guys. Thanks a lot. Monkey loves you. Monkey always loves you. Anyway, see you guys. Bye.